In this video, we're going to go over the items dimension. Now, you notice I'm not navigating as much as I have been. Well, that's because at this point, you guys should be pretty well knowledgeable about where I'm going to go with it. So we're in purchasing items. Items are a dimension that used to be limited to just purchasing an order entry. But over the years, Intacct has expanded its use so that it can be used in pretty much any transaction. You come to a journal entry. Come down here, click in any field to see the details. And you'll see item here as a dimension. So it can be used to code any transaction, and it can be used to pull a report, financial or standard. Come here, come to filters, and you'll see it's available. However, it is not quite as dynamic as departmental locations, but it is useful. And if you notice, include subs, we'll get into this in reporting, but include subs means if you have a parent-child relationship and say you choose just one specific location, say we choose GC Stormcat, any locations under that, if we include subs, will roll up into it. If we don't include subs, just pull for transactions coded to GC. Standard practice is to have include subs. Items don't have that, even though you could possibly have a parent-child relationship. It doesn't do that because that's not its purpose. Now, items, let's see. Maybe I lied to you. Let's see what items allows us to do. Been a while, folks. I haven't messed with it very often. Okay, so what I told you is a lie. You can't do a parent-child relationship with items, which, of course, makes sense. You don't want to do parent-child relationships with items because items are specific things that you are ordering. Now, items, they allow you to do granular reporting on things that you may want to know how much you're spending on or how much you're buying without having to create a separate GL account for each item. So here we have wire mesh wire, black standard face wire, horizontal wall reinforcement trusses. We have green wire, gray wire, yellow wire. If we're not using items and we wanted to track the expense or how much we bought of this, we would have to create a GL account for green wire. We had to create a GL account for gray wire, for yellow wire, for the mesh, wire mesh, for the standard face, for the reinforcing truss, lumber. By using items, what we can do is create an item, and using GL groups, we can code the item to a particular GL group. And then in the transaction definitions, which I'm not going to go too deep into, we can code the transaction definitions to a specific GL account. So, while you're still able to track your purchases and pull reports based on these items, you don't have to create a whole boatload of GL accounts. They'll code one, which is what you want, like cost of sales materials. And maybe all you want the material to be coded to, which is real useful. And so that's what the items are used for. Note, they do not have to be used for just inventory. They can be used for non-inventory. They can be used for services, for fees, for membership subscriptions. Like here, site work. You could do it for finishes, contract SOV, development cost. It does not have to be actual inventory. And indeed, unless you're using the inventory module, most items for most clients will be non-inventory. Now you may say, well, it's inventory to me. Yes, but you're not creating the inventory like a manufacturer would. Now, you could do that, but it's not necessarily most effective. Inventory in this case deals with things that a manufacturer would use to create like a kit or to create product. Like a car manufacturer would have inventory they would track as inventory. If you're building a building, your concrete, your lumber, it's inventory to you, but it's not inventory as Intacct would understand it. I know I'm on a slippery slope here, and I don't want to get too deep into it. need further clarification, talk to your enablement specialist. Right now, just trust me. Most of the time, you're going to be using non-inventory.